Hey, I'm Mike Hudson. I'm the Museum Director at the American Printing House for the Blind, and today we're coming to you from the Educational Aids Department. The first educational aids from the American Printing House for the Blind were very large format tactile relief maps that were introduced in the late 1870s. You could buy a 3x4 puzzle map of Europe in 1880 for $50. Now, all of those original maps were carved one at a time by hand out of plywood. In the 1930s and 40s, we got more serious about it and started mass producing these maps. So it all started out with a master craftsman named William Butler, and he would carve the original prototype of the map out of wood using a combination of electric cutting tools and chisels and that sort of thing. So this is the prototype for the tactile map of Europe, and this is part of Scandinavia. You'll notice that the mountains, the rivers, they're all there in all their layers. The relief is quite exaggerated. If you were to hold a globe of the earth, it wouldn't feel as bumpy as the relief is on this map. Now we have to create our mold. So we would take our wooden prototype, we would coat it with a releasing agent, we would get a wooden frame, like this one, fill it up with a nice bubbly bath of liquid epoxy. And then we would take our mold, our prototype, we would sink it down into that epoxy, lock them together, and wait until the epoxy set. Then the releasing agent would allow our prototype to come popping right out of our mold, and now we've got our mold to make our map pieces. Our next stage is to actually produce the production maps. So this is our production map of the United States. So what they would do is they would use the mold, they would fill it full of either hard rubber or an epoxy mixed with a masonite binder was the raw material. And they would pull that piece out, and then they would take it to a bandsaw, and they would cut out each individual piece. Here we have Indiana. Now, we made these maps in both relief versions with the mountains and the rivers, and we also made them just flat if you just wanted to memorize the shapes of the states. But you can see that each individual piece has been molded, carved, and then painted. Everything had to be painted. We used 5 different colors. So every one of these maps, whether it's Europe or Africa, or in this case, the United States, used these shades of pink and gold and green and kind of a gray purple. And all of the bodies of water, the ocean, the lakes, the streams and rivers, they were always blue. Then of course, the capital cities of each state, in this case, and some of the larger cities, are marked with either black or red brass pins that were sunk after the thing was molded. And that's how we made large format maps. Now, in the 1970s and 80s, we stopped producing these maps because the borders started to change so rapidly that you might spend all this time preparing your mold, and then the Czechs and the Slovaks would decide to separate, and your whole map project had gone out of business. So the only puzzle map that we still make is the United States puzzle map.